November 2023, Sam Altman is fired as CEO of OpenAI. This is completely unexpected, and OpenAI's board gives a single eyebrow-raising reason for the firing. Sam wasn't candid. That afternoon, Ilya Sutskever, OpenAI's chief scientist and co-founder, runs an all-hands meeting, emphasizing that the firing was necessary to protect humanity. A very confusing weekend followed as OpenAI imploded, and it seemed for a little while that Microsoft might be poised to acquire the world's leading AGI lab at a huge discount. But that's not what happened. Instead, Sam made a triumphant return to OpenAI and was able to remake the board.
Let me ask about Ilya. Is he being held hostage in a secret nuclear facility?
No.
Ilya has not spoken publicly since the whole debacle. But from leaks, we know that the trigger for these events revolves around the discovery of an algorithm called Q-Star.
Can you speak to what Q-Star is?
We are not ready to talk about that.
I did a deep dive on what we know about Q-Star back in November, but with new leaks, it seems there's a bit more to this story. And diving into this breakthrough reveals something, lurking just beneath the surface, about OpenAI's plan for AGI, or maybe more aptly, about Sam's plan to not just remake OpenAI's board, but to remake the foundations of our society.
I'm back.
When living through an intelligence explosion, it's difficult to keep track of all of the breakthroughs. But in order to understand where Q-Star fits into all of this, we definitely should take a moment to reflect on Sora, its capabilities, and maybe more importantly, the way in which it was released. Sora is the biggest announcement OpenAI has made since the events of November. They unveiled their video generation model in February of 2024, already light years beyond the competition in terms of generating videos from text. But to call this model a video generation model is akin to reducing a human to nothing more than a coffee metabolizer. In order to do what it does, Sora has to simulate the physical world in motion. This means it needs to build a model of the world, understanding things like physics and object permanence. All of this while it imagines your text prompt evolving through time. The model understands not only what you ask for in the prompt, but also how those things exist in the physical world. There are a lot of really interesting things that went into Sora's training, but for now, I want to focus on the way it was released. A blog post and some excited tweets from Sam's personal account. Compare this to the media blitz that was the release of GPT-4. At this point, OpenAI isn't releasing things to get people to use them, to build up hype for a product. They already have our attention. Now, they make an announcement and unveil technology to garner a social response.
We call it iterative deployment. Part of the reason there is I think AI and surprise don't go together.
They want the world, they want you to start thinking about what all of this means and how it fits into your everyday life. But to look at Sora in isolation only gives you a part of the picture. It's a stepping stone on the path to AGI, just one stepping stone. And when it comes to truly generalized intelligence, there needs to be more.
We have said for a while that we think better reasoning in these systems is an important direction that we'd like to pursue.
This is where Q-Star comes in. To give a quick recap of what we learned about Q-Star back in November, it's a combination of Q-learning with the A-Star search algorithm. This gives the algorithm a mathematically formal way to search through the metaspace of ideas extremely efficiently. One way to think about what it's doing is to think of every possible idea, every possible discovery, and every version of reality existing on a lake, a foggy lake where we can really only see the stepping stones that are right in front of us. In this metaphor, a goal or an objective like create AGI would be an island on this lake. We can make it out in the distance, and we can even see a path toward it if we keep jumping along the stepping stones that lead to it. But this is where a key insight garnered from Q-learning comes into play. Because it turns out, the more ambitious the objective, the more stepping stones we need to cross the lake of ignorance, the more deceptive the objective becomes. Think of a Chinese finger trap, where as you pull your fingers out of the trap closes in, locking the fingers in place. If we approach this problem the way our society approaches most problems, we may define an objective: free our fingers from the trap. That's how our world works. We want to do something, we create a goal, and then with dogged determination, we can get there. We may even define a metric as a proxy for how close we are to achieving our goal. In the case of the finger trap, the proximity of our fingers could be that metric. If our fingers are moving further apart, we are closer to achieving freedom. However, to actually achieve freedom from the trap, we must paradoxically move toward becoming less free in order to loosen the trap so that we can then fully withdraw our fingers. The Chinese finger trap was deliberately designed to be deceptive, but as a metaphor, it highlights the natural deception that exists in objective-based thinking. In their book, Greatness Cannot Be Planned, former OpenAI researchers Kenneth Stanley and Joel Lehman cite many examples of this deception playing out throughout the history of our society. In 1928, bacteriologist Alexander Fleming was conducting research, and before leaving for a two-week vacation, he left a bunch of petri dishes stacked on his workbench containing cultures of bacteria. When he got back, he checked the dishes and realized he messed up. He let a mold contaminate one of the dishes. But before throwing all of it out, he noticed that the area immediately surrounding the mold was clear of bacteria. This seemed interesting and made Alexander curious. He spent more time with it and eventually extracted the mold juice and realized it could fight all kinds of bacteria. He called it penicillin. It was that accidental discovery and the later mass producing of it that changed the tide of World War II, saving countless lives by treating bacterial infections among soldiers and civilians. If your objective was to win World War II, you might have never realized that the stepping stone you need to achieve that goal involves petri dishes. The common theme among the great scientific discoveries throughout history is that they rely much more on serendipitous circumstances than our rational minds care to admit.
I think when a system can significantly increase the rate of scientific discovery in the world, that's like a huge deal. I believe that most real economic growth comes from scientific and technological progress.
And when it comes to grand objectives like creating AGI, it turns out if we let go of objective-based thinking, the focus on the result, and instead focus on that which drives our curiosity, that which is interesting to us, we can make progress. Just maybe not in the way we had originally planned. This is a mindset shift. It means letting go of the comfort of objectives, breaking free from the path it provides, breaking free from the metrics and the measurements that act as guardrails on that road, and instead embracing the new, the interesting, and the weird. If we imagine a simulated environment where we are trying to train a robotics model to walk and navigate to a door, the traditional approach to this would be to define the objective: go through the door. We could then define a metric, like how close it got to the door on the last run, and then optimize the model for that metric. But there's another way, and this is at the heart of the self-play that Q-learning allows. Instead of focusing on increasing the proximity to the goal, we get rid of the goal. Instead, we define and keep track of the behaviors that the model produces in each run. So if we let it loose and it immediately runs itself into a wall, that's great. We learned something. Now we run the model again. Maybe it does the same thing, just to the other side of the wall. Okay, that's not really new. We already know how to run into walls now. So the system would give the model negative feedback in this case. On the next run, the robot trips and slithers toward the wall. Oh, this is interesting and new. Positive feedback. And we keep doing this over and over and over again with no clear objective in mind. The only thing we are trying to do is collect stepping stones on that foggy lake of ignorance. In this way, the model is being trained based on a novelty-based search algorithm, as opposed to an objective-based algorithm. Its goal is to learn about its environment through experimentation. It becomes a treasure hunter, collecting stepping stones, not knowing or caring where those stepping stones lead, but instead taking each step in the discovery process as a victory. It turns out this approach is remarkably effective. A robot told just to try new things will eventually learn to avoid walls, navigate a hallway, and open doors, despite none of those things being rewarded or requested as objectives.
Language is a very approximate representation of our percepts and our mental models, right? I mean, there's a lot of tasks that we accomplish where we manipulate a mental model of the situation at hand, and that has nothing to do with language.
It's becoming clear in the world of AI that language models alone are not enough to achieve AGI. This is where large language models, Sora and QStar, begin to come together. QStar is OpenAI's attempt to enhance a model's reasoning capability. The latest leak on the project comes from an anonymous source and talks about the implementation of an energy-based model to aid in complex problem solving. This was often a criticism of early language models, that they are just predicting the next token in the sequence. Even when you give a model prompts like, let's think step by step, which, by the way, is very effective at getting it to make a plan before answering a prompt. Once it starts answering your prompt, it can't go back and explore other thought process. In other words, once it starts answering, it's just predicting the next token in that same thought process. Now, let's imagine a system with Sora's world simulation capabilities combined with a large language model and QStar. We can think of these components as different parts of the system's brain, where the energy-based model acts as a way to judge the energy or compatibility of a particular thought process produced by the other models in the system. In other words, the overall system can think and reason about different approaches to a problem before answering. This is giving the model a way to optimize abstract representation space, a way to optimize its thoughts. QStar can engage in a form of internal deliberation, considering various potential responses and ideas before converging on the most compatible one. This is not unlike how humans might reason through a complex problem, weighing different options and possibilities before arriving at a solution. The key insight here is in the way QStar abandons the notion of a single, predefined objective in favor of an open-ended search for optimal responses. This allows the model to explore a broader space of possibilities, leading to more creative and more insightful outputs. In other words, it makes it extremely smart, willing to explore different ideas to arrive at the best answer.
I think the really special thing happening is that it's not like it gets better in this one area and worse at others. It's getting like better across the board. That's, I think, super cool.
As we learn to build ever more capable machine learning models, we are also uncovering profound insights about our own nature and the world we live in. The development of AI is not just about creating intelligent machines. It's also about understanding the essence of intelligence, creativity, and discovery. Models like QStar are teaching us that the path to breakthrough lies not in single-minded pursuit of predefined objectives, but in the open-ended exploration of possibilities. As a society, we are entering uncharted territory here. There are many exciting and important stepping stones we need to find before we can unlock humanity's full potential. But to do that, we must learn to embrace the same open-ended process of discovery that machines are now learning to embrace. Imagine a society where you wake up each day and pursue whatever sparks your curiosity and interest. Imagine taking the lessons of QStar and applying them to the entire fabric of society. we have an unprecedented opportunity to transform our objective-obsessed culture into one that values the treasure hunter over the taskmaster, a society that prioritizes exploration, creativity, and serendipity over rigid planning and metric chasing. To be clear, this is not about abandoning all structure and purpose, but about recognizing that the greatest achievements often come from unexpected places. It's about creating an environment that nurtures our innate curiosity and rewards the pursuit of the interesting and the novel. As we stand on the precipice of the AI revolution, we have a choice. We can cling to our old ways, trying to force the future into the mold of the past, or we can embrace the lessons of our most advanced AI systems and reimagine what's possible for ourselves. The path forward is not a straight line to a predefined destination. It's a winding journey of discovery, with each stepping stone revealing new vistas and new possibilities. So let us break free from the tyranny of objectives and metrics. Let us become explorers and treasure hunters in the grand adventure of life. And let us build a society that celebrates the serendipitous over the planned, the interesting over the expected, and the endlessly creative potential of the human spirit. But the impact of QStar doesn't end here. If you want to take the next step in the journey of discovery and learn more about the notion that ideas and rules may be as fundamental to understanding the laws of physics as particles and forces, then watch this video next.